understand the importance of having a whole nother sound. See, when God told Joshua and the army to march around the walls of Jericho, what did he tell them to make at the end? He said, I need y'all to make a sound. I need you to make a noise that your enemy. Is there anybody in this building that's going to say on today, I'm going to make a noise that the enemy has never heard before? I know you heard me crying. I know you heard me depressed. I know you heard me calling my girlfriends. But on today, that's not the noise I'm going to be making. If I make any noise, it's going to be to bless the Lord. Samuel 6, where David danced till his clothes fell off. And so often we read that text and we really think that David's clothing fell off. And it did. He was wearing any five that could fall off. But I'm looking at some of our outfits today, and I understand that no matter how hard you dance, your clothes ain't gonna come off. But can I tell you what clothes represents? Clothes represents that which you're in, which it looks like you cannot come out. That just went over your head. David danced until what looked like he was in, and it looked like he wasn't going to come out. He danced so hard because he was grateful for what he had come up out of. You understand that by the time David was dancing that hard, he was rejoicing because he found out that the thing that he thought was a loss, they had now gotten back. Can I tell you, baby, you hadn't lost it, you're about to get it back. Can I tell you, it belongs to you, so it's got to come back. See, that's why you can stop crying and being frustrated on some of this stuff that you ain't got in your house, because I read somewhere that even though it's not in your possession, it's still up under God's control. Is anybody going to give God a praise for what's under his control? It's not under my control. I don't have enough power, but I serve a God who is all powerful. So I'll dance until my mind comes back. I'll dance until I get my joy back. I'll dance until I get my strength back. I'll dance until I get my breakthrough. I will dance until that which looks unmovable now has to move. Genesis 19 and 30. Lot and his two daughters left Zoar and settled in the mountains, for he was afraid to stay in Zoar. He and his two daughters lived in a cave. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, it's dangerous to live yourself. What am I living in that God never said I had to live in? These were my own limitations that I put on myself. Why? Because I was afraid. I was afraid. And so in your fear, it says that they lived in a cave. Remember, I told you it's dangerous to live in a cave. Do you know why it's dangerous to live in a cave? Because a cave is so small, you'll think that that's all that there is. See, some of us, we chose him because we thought that's all that there was. See, I'm going to say that again. Because some days I preach, some days I teach, some days I prophesy, but you're going to get wisdom up in here today. I'm sick of my saved sisters in the Lord complaining that you ain't got no man, but your life consists of work, home, church, and a grocery store. Y'all don't like it, so I'm going to say it again. I'm sick of my saved sisters in the Lord complaining that you ain't got no man, but your life consists of work, home, church, and a grocery store. You're living in a cave. You can't even see that there's a whole world out there. You can't even see that God has more. God has greater. God has better. Your actions are not limited to. But you would never know that if you don't come about your cave. High five your girlfriend and say, baby, I'm coming about this cave. There's more to life than this. I'm not going to sit up in here. I'm going to hop on somebody's plane. I'm about to go down the Navy Pier and treat my own self to a nice dinner. I'm about to go down to Michigan Ave. I'm about to hit up Gucci. And if I can't buy it, I'm going to look at it. But I'm going to do something with my life besides dwelling in a cave. So they lived in a cave. And in their cave, in the place where they couldn't see nothing, they make a decision. See, it's dangerous to make a decision when you can't see nothing. I just said something right there. It's dangerous to make a decision when you can't see anything. And so in the place where they couldn't see what was around them, they couldn't see what was ahead of them, they couldn't see what was on top of them, they make a decision. And it says, one day the older daughter said to the younger, our father is old and there is no man around here to lie with us. Can I tell you something, women of God? When there's no men here, you go there. Oh, I just messed up somebody. Because see, I didn't say chase a man, but I'm going to clean it up in about 2 minutes. When there's no men here, you go there. What are you saying, prophetess? Because y'all ain't going to lie on me. Y'all ain't going to say prophetess said chase a man. That ain't what I said. When there's no men here, you go there. In other words, come out of your cave and live your life, baby. Ain't nothing in a cave but what you took there. Somebody needs to catch that. The only thing in a cave is what you took there. That's why when they looked around that cave, the only something they could see was each other and they daddy. Can I tell you, some of us are guilty of acting like these women? We're guilty of that. You think Chicago is the whole world. Baby, somebody need to get you a Southwest flight to Vegas. Somebody need to fly you to Los Angeles. Somebody need to fly you to Houston. You need to come to the ATL, shawty. You need to take it down to the MIA. You need to understand that there is more to life than what you see. You think that the Chicago loop is all that there is. See, that's really the problem with the women in this text, is they think they got a handle on God. They think that they know all that's in the world. Can I tell you what's so sad? Is Zoar is just a city. So you complaining about what's in a city when God has got a whole planet. Oh, you do understand that when you look at what the word Zoar means small. So you're in a small place. And you have the audacity to act like where you are is all that God has.